large public events are common, from marathons to large professional sporting events to 4th of July celebrations. As a doctor and an economist, I wonder, well, what happens to people who live in the vicinity of those events? What happens if they actually need medical care? We looked at older Americans above the age of 65 who happened to live in the vicinity of a marathon but were unlikely to be marathon participants. And we studied whether or not their likelihood of dying within 30 days of having a heart attack or cardiac arrest was different if they had that on the day of a marathon versus the surrounding dates. What we found were some interesting findings. For every 100 people that had a heart attack or cardiac arrest, an additional 4 would die if they happened to have that on the date of a marathon. We also looked at whether or not ambulances took longer to get to the hospital. We found that they took on average about 4 minutes longer, which is about a 30% increase in the time required to get a patient to the hospital. One might wonder whether 4 minutes really could matter. If you look at other studies of people who come into the hospital with heart attacks, the time from when they walk into the ED with a heart attack symptom to when they have a stent open up their artery is a golden window, and if that window is too long, heart muscle dies and people do worse. This extends beyond marathons to all sorts of large public events. Cities need strategies to ensure that people who live in affected areas can get healthcare quickly if they need it.